So in that, the most important one, impulse signal. So the first one and important one, impulse signal. So it is also called as Dirac delta function. Dirac delta function. So for every signal, there will be a standard notation. So for the impulse signal, del of t is a standard notation. If I write del of t in the further slides, in the further videos, so you understand that as an impulse signal. So I should not speak again, impulse signal. Just simply I'll write the notation. So del of t is a impulse signal representation. So now, this is a functional representation. This is a graphical representation. So in the functional representation, how the signal is changing with respect to the independent variable. At t is equal 0, what about the signal amplitude? At t is equal to 1, what about the signal amplitude? At t is equal to infinity, what about the signal amplitude? So like that, over the range of entire t, from minus infinity to infinity, so what will be the signal amplitude is the types. So the impulse signal exists only at t is equal 0. The impulse signal exists only at t is equal 0. Exist means at t is equal 0, the signal must have some amplitude, that is infinity. So at t is equal 0, the signal is having some infinite amplitude. And the rest of the t, that is positive t and negative t values, so the signal is 0. The signal is having the amplitude 0. The signal is having the amplitude 0. So this is an ideal case. This is an ideal case. Practically, we'll get some values. Practically, we'll get some values, amplitude. So in practical, how we'll get that value? So let us consider a stripe which is in rectangle shape, having width delta, a very small value, and height 1 by delta. If I want to calculate the area of the signal, so obviously a rectangular area is length into breadth. So delta into 1 by delta, I got the area is 1. So area under the curve. Area under the curve. So that if I calculate the integration over the range of that curve, I can find the area. So I got the area is 1. So obviously that is 1. Then unit means the amplitude is 1. The amplitude of the signal or area of the signal is 1. So the area of the signal integral minus infinity to infinity del of t dt is 1. So now, for example, I have some amplitude A. I have some amplitude A. Then what will be its area? And how much area I will get is? So obviously, A is a constant, keep aside. And in the overall integration over minus infinity to infinity del of t, the signal exists only at t is equal to 0. So at t is equal to 0, how much its value? 1. So obviously I'll get A. So in the similar, just instead of A, I've given the 5. So like this questions is helpful in the competitive point of view. So concentrate. And next we'll move on to the next signal, that is step signal. So which is the most important one, because I am going to use this step signal in the further signal representations. So this is the important signal. So now equation means functional representation. T greater than or equal to 0. T greater than or equal to 0 means for 0 and for positive values. 0 and positive values, there is some amplitude. There is some amplitude A. And the rest remaining place less than 0 means negative values of t. So there is, the value is 0. If amplitude is equal to 1, the signal is called unit step signal. So the standard notation for unit step signal, so u of t is a unit step signal. So now next move on to the third basic signal, ramp signal. So its mathematical function x of t is equal to kt. So if same, this is also same as the step signal. T is equal to 0 and positive values, it will take the amplitude at. For negative values, it will take the amplitude 0. For t is equal to 0, the value is a. T is equal to 1, for t is equal to 0, x of t value 0. For t is equal to 1, x of t value a. So as the t changes, x of t changes. So which is linearly changing. So ramp signal is a linear signal. Again same. If a is equal to 1, a means amplitude. So if amplitude is 1, that is called as unit ramp signal. So ramp, the first letter here is given as standard notation. So we'll move on to the next signal, parabolic signal. So the functional representation, parabolic signal. The functional representation x of t is equal to a t square by 2. So for various values of t, the x of t will change. Again the same, the independent variable same as step signal and ramp signal. So it will, the amplitude exists for 0 and positive values of t. For negative values of t, the signal amplitude is 0. For t is equal to 0, x of t value 0. For t is equal to 1, a by 2. For t is equal to 2, 2a. So like that, it will show you a plot. So parabolic signal standard notation, p of t. And the unit parabolic signal means again, the amplitude a value will be 1. So far we have discussed the standard 4 signals. So these four are very standard signals, and simply one quick review. So the del of t exists only at t is equal to 0. And the remaining u of t, r of t, p of t, the signal exists at t greater than or equal to 0. We'll move on to the next signal, that is rectangular pulse or gate function or unit pulse signal. So all the three together were same name. So pulse signal. Pulse means it is having some width. Pulse is having some width. Width means the signal exists over the some interval. So beyond that interval, the signal is 0. The signal amplitude exists over some interval. Beyond the interval, the signal is 0. So here between minus a by 2, the signal is having some amplitude, or 1 by a or something, some amplitude. And the remaining, the signal value will be, at the remaining, the signal value will be 0. And this side also, greater than a by 2. At this side also, greater than a by 2, the signal value is 0. Okay. So, that it looks like a rectangle. So, that's why the name came, rectangular pulse. So, in another way also, so you can represent its mathematical. Here I have given you the two mathematical functions. So, it is one, the signal amplitude exists between minus a by 2 to a by 2. And in the second way, so this is a second way. This is a second way, u of t plus 1 by 2 to minus u of t minus 1 by 2. So, here, so u of t plus 1 by 2. As I said you already, by seeing u of t, what did you understand? U of t means which type of signal it is? Unit step signal. But without writing u of t, I have written here u of t plus 1 by 2 means some operation has done on the unit step signal. So that you are going to discuss in the later videos, and the next topic is that one only. But right now we need to learn the unit pulse. So, just simply u of t plus 1 by 2 means advanced signal. U of t minus 1 by 2 is a delayed signal. And its addition gives you the unit pulse signal. And how much width for that signal? So, the width means the signal existing place is the width. between -0.5 to 0.5 is the width. So how much total for the 1? So the width of the pulse is 1. We'll move on to the next slide. So sinusoidal and exponential signals. So these are very important signals, because in the most of the differential equations solving, so you are using that signals. So the standard notation for the sinusoidal signal, A sine 2 pi f naught t, or A sine omega naught t. So here f naught is the normal fundamental frequency, here omega naught is the angular frequency. So you know very well about the relation between the angular frequency and fundamental frequency. So here omega naught is equal to 2 pi by f naught, where f naught is equal to 1 by t naught, because frequency and time period are in inversely proportional, where t is a time period. So that is a standard representation of the sinusoidal signal. So now we'll see about the exponential signal here itself. So the exponential signal means x of t is equal to a some amplitude e power a t. So this is a real. A will take only the real values. So that is why it is a real exponential. And another way, a into e power j omega naught t. That means a of cos omega naught t plus j sin omega naught t. Complex exponential signal. So where theta is a phase of the sinusoidal signal, a is amplitude obviously. I told you already about f naught, normal frequency or fundamental frequency. Omega naught is a radian frequency. So now let us see the plots of the sinusoidal signal, and it's another trigonometrical one, cosine, cos signal or cosinusoidal signal. So let us see those two plots. So x of t is equal to sin t. T is equal to 0. Sin 0 how much? 0. Sin pi by 2. At t is equal to pi by 2, sin pi by 2 how much in the trigonometry? 1. And what about sin pi? At t is equal to pi, what about sin pi? 0. Okay. So like that, I can plot the sinusoidal signal. In the same way, cosinusoidal signal, that is known as cos signal. So obviously the trigonometric term cos, I will take the different values, already you know. So how much cos 0? Cos 0, 1. And cos pi by 2, 0. So like that, if I take in the various values of t, I can plot the cosinusoidal signal, cos signal. So next, x of t is equal to e power a t. So the real exponential signal plot. If a is positive, what will be the plot? And if a is negative, what will be the plot? That means e power a t. So if I take the values, obviously I'll take the values over the range minus infinity to infinity. Minus infinity to infinity. If t is equal to minus infinity, e power minus infinity, what will be its value? 0. Then at t is equal to 0, e power 0 means 1. So next, e power at a maximum value infinity, at e power infinity means infinity. So from minimum to maximum. From minimum to maximum, lowest to highest. So the signal looks like exponentially increasing one. Now e power minus a t. So again from the lowest to highest. So x of minus infinity. Already it is a minus is there. Here minus is there. Minus into minus plus. E power infinity will be. So it will start from infinity and end to the 0. So here e power a t is a exponentially increasing function. E power minus a t is a decreasing or decaying exponential function. Next, the most important one, sinc function. So it is famous in the digital communications because of orthogonality concept. So that way you can understand in the latter communication subjects, in the your digital communications will be there. So just here, I would like to show you the plot and its function. So the sinc function will be x of t is equal to sin t by t over the range total, over the entire independent variable range, over minus infinity to infinity. So then we'll observe at t is equal to 0, what will be the signal? At t is equal to infinity, what will be the signal? At t is equal to minus infinity. So if I write t is equal to 0, if I write t is equal to 0 means sin 0 by 0. So 0 by 0 is an indeterminate form. So you'll be having in the plus 1 and plus 2 mathematics clearly. If any term is in the indeterminate form, means we have to apply the L'Hospital rule. simply in the limits, so limit t tends to 0, sin theta by theta will take the value 1. So at t is equal to 1, sin theta by theta is a 1. Then from that the signal will decrease. So at infinity plus, the completely the signal will be 0. So the signal will decrease slowly. So here at x is equal to 0, the maximum, the signal will be maximum. So next signal, that is signum. So which is signum function, which looks like unit step signal only, but so the signum function at t greater than or equal to 0, so the value will be 1. At t is equal to 0, it is obviously 0. And at t less than 0, it will take the amplitude of minus 1. Over the entire range of negative independent variable, over the entire negative t values, so the amplitude will be minus 1. And there will be sudden discontinuity. Sudden discontinuity will occur at t is equal to 0. So then 0, and over the entire positive range, so the signal amplitude will be 1. And the last signal, that is unit triangular function. So as the name itself is suggesting you, the shape of the signal looks like a triangle. And the signal is defined again same over the some range, minus 1 to 1. So between minus 1 to 0, the signal function will be t plus 1, this line t plus 1, a line equation, this is t plus 1, and again 0 to 1, so there will be another line equation, that is minus t plus 1. So if I take a plot for this, it looks like a triangular function.